Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to have 5120 in action. I know, skill! 3.33 seconds inner creep reload sucks! Fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, it is not that horrible as a tank, and we will try to make this vehicle work, alright? Our score, which we will try to get today, will be 4000. And for equipment pieces, we are going to use ventilation, stabilizer, and aiming device. Obviously, you can make tanks so much better if you are using the special equipment without any doubts whatsoever. But once again, for a budget purposes, we are using this kind of standard equipment, which everyone can afford and which can everyone use. By the way, you were the ones which was voting for this kind of equipment, so don't you dare to complain. Okay, so what do we have? We have the tier 10 matchmaking, but we have quite a bit of the tier 8s too, so pretty much it is a tier, we are middle tier tank in this situation. Okay, how to make the things work? This is the question. Obviously, our goal would be to... Let me figure this out. I am trying to think how we can make this thing work, and I believe playing in the middle is going to be the best thing what we can do. Hopefully from the middle we will make a good decisions. Enemies will make some... Katita? Am I bothering you? Katia? Honey? Katita? Okay, no comments there. Katita out of nowhere jumped on the table. She said, so you are not happy, peasant. And she said, "Phew." And she pretty much left. I don't even know what I'm supposed to say about this. Okay, we are sitting already over there, so they are pretty much countering everything, my friends. I mean, this EBR will counter our guys which is sitting there. So only one way how I can imagine playing this battle would be to be patient and to holy fucking F. This is no bueno. This is no bueno. Now the question is, from where am I getting spotted? Did that EBR spotted me from there, or what the flying F is happening? Because this guy is going to win the game for enemy forces. Looking at this, that's pretty damn clear. He's sitting there. Yep. Not a big surprise. I know I'm very, very well aware of this. And you know what? This kind of greediness cost him a game. Very, very good. He should not shoot me, but he decided to go for it anyway. So, you know what? I am feeling pretty damn good. I'm returning to the middle once again, because from the middle you are the most flexible. And plus, on top of that, our 430 blind shot at the wood is very, very, very good start for our team. Obviously, speaking about our start, how we are, how much use we are getting from all this, I believe it's fair to say we are getting absolutely nothing. Which is quite sad, but in the same time, I know I can't change anything about this. Anyways, we are in position. This is where I want to be for now, and let's see, can we beat the living crap out of the enemies which is playing there. Fava and Estrava still never ever was spotted. Keep this in mind, my friends. Keep this in mind. Interesting. Wait, we have all time in the world of tanks, fellas. You see, like you saw in the 5100 video, it is absolutely the same situation as 5100. You cannot be too aggressive, because if you are going to say, "Oh, we can bang them all," you will regret your life choices faster than I can talk. And believe me, fellas, I can talk pretty damn fast. Pixel shot not even worth to try, as wrong as it sounds. It is just not worth it. Wait for it. Hmm. Enemies lost quite a lot of HP, but not as much as our progetto by trying to make pressure. That was pretty damn silly, but once again, well deserved in the same time. It was way too aggressive for our guy. Ay, 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 ay. Can we eliminate the 430? Yes, we can. Beautiful. Okay, that's the first damaging shot and the first kill, which I am pretty damn happy about. And we are feeling great. Although object 705 decided to be quite aggressive against our CS-53. And I hope our CS-53 will be able to spot... if necessary. He's thinking about going and making pressure, but not so fast, my friend, not so fast. Okay, how about if you would get just tiny touch closer there? Is it worth it or it's not worth it? That's the question. So first of all, okay, we will spot if the Conqueror will try to go in front. And once again, this is what I'm thinking about and this is what I am dreaming about in the same time. Oh, ho, 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 ho. That's autoloader. Wait, wait, wait. Aim, aim, aim. Take our time. Boom, that's one. Come on, one more and we will have a perfect clip. Yeah, beautiful. So now we have 1,200 damage, 2 kills. We are a very important part of this game. So far we have a great start, honestly. Even though we are in 5 minutes into the battle, but this is the map where you cannot make pressure through the heavy side, and playing somewhere there with 50, 120 would be pretty damn silly, don't you think so? So playing in this position is kind of only one play which we are capable of doing. Now the question is, okay, they would be able to beat the living crap out of me. This is definitely not what I'm looking for, but oh well, not much what we can change about this either way. Panther, Panther is trying to be safe, and indeed he is safe already. Okay, look. Our 430 is thinking he can flank the Conqueror, but he forgot about the Fava. I am going to give him tip. Fava is right here, but once again, if our guy will do the silly goose decision, he is pretty much doomed. Okay, Conqueror is thinking about coming back, which would be much appreciated. Let's see, can we find a nice shot to this guy? Sure thing we can. Beautiful. Can we get another one? No, we cannot. This reload time between the shells can be a big pain in the ass, and I believe I do not need to explain why. Although the question is now, do we want to go for this Fava yet, or we do not want to go for Fava? Who is not spotted? Starva and Cow, aka AMX AC48. It is okay. Aha, we are getting spotted. What that means? That means someone is doing pretty damn good job. Probably there is Starva which is sitting around this area. That's okay. We have all time in the World of Tanks. We are making pressure like there is no tomorrow. It should take another 10 seconds or so for Fava to reload, so we are going to be quite involved right here. We are finding this guy. We are trying to track him. Unfortunately, we fail doing so, but we should be just fine now, unless the things won't go that well. It is okay, we tracked this guy, we did our clip, and now we are away, we escaped. Good. Very, very good. Exactly what I want to see, and this is what I want, my friends. This is exactly what I want. So now we will have a full clip. We are sitting on 2,700 damage, which is nice. Maybe I could simply drag this guy or ram this guy, but once again, there is no need for us to panic. We have all time in the World of Tanks and everything is fine. AMX Liberty is saying they have a bushwhacker here, which is not a big surprise, I believe. So all we need to do, we need to wait. Meanwhile, our 430 and CS53 is going for this Fava, and here we go. Now we are talking. Good, this guy is dead. Starva is sitting right here, doesn't really matter. I'm thinking about beating the living crap out of the Panther too, and we should be able to do so. That's one for the team, doesn't really matter. Starva is trying to be quite more involved still. We are okay. And no, who asked you to let me on fire, you asshole? Ay, 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 ay. Well, here we go. That's how we are finishing our first game. I do not really complain about this performance. I think our game was kind of top-notch that and we simply was quite unlucky to be lit on fire. If not this fire, I believe we would be able to eliminate the Starva from the game to clip him and probably get one more clip. Still, 3,800 damage. Oh. This is okay. Let's teleport into the end of this game, shall we? Let's go. And we are back, fellas. Game over of the first game. Game over of the first game. Sounds very, very weird. Anyways, hip hip hooray, this is victory. Our Death Stars won the game, which is very, very nice. And overall, I know I could get a bit more in this game, but it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. I'm still relatively fine with my games, even though it is 3 in the morning when we are recording everything. Unfortunately, this guy was very, very greedy. He could win the game for enemy team, but he did a very, very stupid thing in order to shoot me. But I get the point. I have a red ass, so why the heck not to punish Baboon for that, right? Anyways, let's go for a second game. And what is our plan? Our plan is to hopefully improve our score. And fellas, one very, very important question which I have you to ask. What do you think about the 5120? Do you think the tank is very, very bad, as a lot of people are saying, because of the 3 seconds inner clip reload? Or what do you think? Or maybe it's not that bad. I'm very, very curious and I would love to. And I would love to know. Himmelsdorf. This is good. This is absolutely amazing for us. Although 30 seconds reload time, I'm wondering where I could punish enemies. Do I need to go to the golf 3 position or not? This is the question. The thing is, our view range is not that great. Maybe I could go on top of the hill. Maybe I could. Maybe I should. You know what? I'm going on top of the hill. I hope this is going to be worth it. And I hope this is going to pay off for us. So as you can see, we have a relatively good speed. We should overtake the Panther 2 even. Yep, indeed we will. And hopefully enemies will have, like, I don't even know, a couple of guns which is playing there. Although we have only 3 guys which is going on top of the hill. So what that means? Maybe, just maybe, fellas, we could get the first clip and after that escape. Maybe this is the right way to play this battle. So I'm not going to be too involved there. I think taking this position will be the right option for us. Honestly, I could go right there, but in the same time, if Artas relocated there, they will be pre-aimed, and I do not really think it is worth it. So instead of being super aggressive, we are going to play relatively passively. But before everything, I want to check out who is living on the corner, and maybe we could smack him. That's one shot. Okay. One shot is better than zero, remember. And once again, I want to be Artas safe, just in case, obviously. Okay, we have 53 TP, we have a Panther, and we have the T10, which decided to be very aggressive. That's good. Okay, so let's beat the living crap. Oh, let's beat the living crap out of them. That's one for the team. Okay, okay, not that bad. That's 2 for the team. Oh, right. I see. Definitely not Russian tank, da? Okay, what I supposed to do about this? We know they have 5 guns here, we have 3 guns here. We are trying to escape. This T10, unfortunately for us, is very, very lucky. Unfortunately for him, he is not taking that much damage as he's supposed to. I'm politely asking our guy to escape from here before it's too late, because this is only one thing what we can do. And I thought we are going to start everything by opening the cliff, to the enemies which is playing on top of the hill. But as you can see, I don't really think it is going to pay off. But that's okay. Okay. That's good. Exactly what we need. What do you think? Bizonte is sitting here or not really? By the looks of it, Bizonte is not there. Okay, how about if we would try to support our 53 TP? I would love to be the living crap out of this Bizonte which is going down there, and can we do this? Okay, T-34, not big deal, that's one for the team. I want to hit him once again, that's two for the team, and I'm going on the reload. I'm not going to search for the next shell. I do not really think it's worth it. I would rather have the full clip, and I would be prepared to be the living crap out of the Bizonte and T-34 for obvious reasons. So yeah, very very unfortunate for our 53 TP. I'm reloading, but once again I cannot do absolutely anything about this. 10 seconds left. Both of those guys are down to one shotable, but we should be relatively fine. 3, 2, 1. This guy is dead. Now T-34 turn. He might look directly at us. Luckily it's not the case. That's very good. Can we eliminate him from the game? Question mark. Answer is sure thing we can. Beautiful. And we are going on the reload. We know the T-54 Echo 1 is sitting on top of the hill. We are very very well aware of this. He have autoloader, I have autoloader. I'm reloading for 20 seconds. Question is how many HP he has. This is the question, because I'm down to 3 shotable, and how the things are looking like for him. And if I'm not mistaken, he should be able to pretty much out DPM me, because his reload of the inner clip is way 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 quicker than mine. Isn't it the case, sir? And you call this tank? And you call this tank? Unbelievable. Okay, let's see. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Yes, full. Game over. I do not really think we will be able to do absolutely anything for him. So let it be. Oh, so that's how the things are looking like. Cool. A bit of the RAM. Oh, wait a second. He should definitely reload quicker than I will. That's a bit of the problem. But we are luring him for our Artis, and hopefully our Artis will be the living crap out of him. That's only one hope which I have. That's okay. No complaints. No regrets. All good. Okay. He banged me. But once again, not the worst game ever. Considering how everything went for us, I would rate this battle as a solid banana out of 10. And I can explain you why am I rating this battle so damn good. Because if not those two shells towards the T10 in the start of the battle, where we clearly supposed to do damage, it would be 4,500 combined, and I would feel very very good. Either way, it is definitely not the score which I should be sad about. It's not like we did one clip or half of the clip and we died. That's completely okay. So let's teleport into the end of this battle, shall we? Boom. And we are back, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Boom! Here you go. The game is over. Our team managed to win this very, very good. We finished with a 4,000 combined. Nice. Can we have the last game a bit better, please? That would be much appreciated. I would love to get like 5,000 damage, like 2,000 assisting damage, but probably I'm asking a bit too much. Anyways, 3,700 damage, 300 assisting damage, like I said before, second by experience, first by the damage, and we even made profit, which is always nice and always welcome. Also, lucky T10. Good. Last game, let's see. By the way, if you are wondering what is there, this is a new pillow, fellas. Sometimes pillow can purr and sometimes pillow can meow. Okay, what do we have, my friends? I would say... Okay, okay, okay. I would say we can beat the living crap out of the enemies which will try to play in the heavy line. This is only one way how we can do the things. Ehrfeld is obviously not the greatest map of all time for obvious reasons. I think it is pretty damn sad, but in the same time, not much what we can do about this. You know, you cannot pick up your map rotation. Although, to be fair with you, if that would be possible, I would play all the time Ehrfeld, so I would learn how to play this map properly and I would love it. If you do not like something, just do more of it until you will get used to that and so will stop complaining. Okay, let's see. Actually, you know what? I changed my mind. I want to take this position instead. The main reason why am I thinking about this position, I think there could be one guy which is sleeping and he's saying F this shit and I'm just making pressure like this. If we are going to have this situation, this is going to be excellent for us. Panther 2, that's nice. Patience. Is he going to go up? Because it looks like he might. Not exactly what I need. But in the same time, I don't really think I could change it. Although maybe I could. Let's destroy these ruins. Or those ruins. And now we can beat the living crap out of his ass. One more. Not worth it. Not worth it. Go on the reload skill. Don't be greedy. This is the most important battle which we had so far. And obviously we want to score very, very well. Requesting support. This is exactly what we need. And obviously, fellas, I am trying to focus on the game to the maximum. I believe that's quite clear and it is very, very important for us. Because if we won't focus on this game, then no one will. I could potentially try to cross, but once again, is it worth it? Was that could hit us like this? Actually, you know what? F it. Let's try to cross. Good. Look, we are going to be so much more involved into this battle. We will try to beat the living crap out of the phase one which is sitting right here. Or hopefully we can eliminate him from the game. Good. Very, very good. Both of the shots, unfortunately, we are the low rolls, but that's completely fine. Let's try to outspot the Lorraine which is playing here. What do you think about this? I'm going to go on the reload. I am feeling completely well. And yeah, I know I lost quite a bit of HP. I cannot change anything about this. Mistakes were made. Please don't jump on me. Please don't jump on me. Please don't jump on me. Okay, Lorraine. No. Arta, maybe you can send Lorraine to the hell. That would be much appreciated. And obviously we have the CS-59 which is playing in the middle. Which is extremely, extremely annoying and disgusting part for us. But in the same time, I know I cannot do absolutely anything about this. Now the question is, could we... could we hit the Indian Panzer? The thing is, he's sitting pretty damn safely here. I mean, honestly, we cannot find a good angle to eliminate him from the game. Plus, on top of that, we have CS, which is dead. Beautiful. Okay, so can we start eliminating one shots which is playing here? This is the question. 430 sitting right here. That's good. Vaka is sitting here. Okay, good information. And 430 just fired. Oh, come on, game. No, can we? It was way too close, fellas. It was definitely way too close. I'm going on the reload right here. Whew. Okay, 79 HP. I am playing way too aggressively. I'm kind of disappointed with my decisions, what I'm doing here, and I have a feeling our heavy line is kind of taking one for the team, so we need to figure out the way how to make the things work. Meanwhile, there is Vazevichus going on top of the hill right here. Question is, can we do something for him, because he's farming our TS5 for our Patriot. I know exactly what will happen. Do you know what will happen? Look at this. Vaza is thinking about making some pressure for us, and obviously he will do this. So now the question is, can we double track him and clip him? Because if not, we are absolutely doomed, and we can forget our name and forgot about this, about succeeding in this game. Oh, he crossed like this. That's interesting. Our board is making pressure for him. Okay, very nice. Nah, he's running away. It is not worth for us to join the board, because we are not as quick and agile as he is. And once again, this could lead us to get completely banged. Okay. Moment of truth. Can we beat the living hell out of the people which is sitting here? Boom. That's one for the team, which is always good and always welcome. The Krivrivron action shit was kind of looking at us, but now he changed his mind, which is very good. But we have Vaka, which is looking directly for us. Definitely not the best performance, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, but honestly, I do not really know what I could do differently here. With all respect, I would love to say, yeah, we can do this, that, this, that, and we would be fine, but the situation is completely different, and the situation is pretty much way shittier than I would ever want to see. But it's okay. Let it be. No complaints, no regrets. Let's hit the killing shot there. Like I said, let's hit the killing shot there. Ooh. Okay, fair enough. Look. 2,700 damage and 600 assisting damage, and considering what kind of map we had, yeah, I mean, it's Airfield. Let it be. The last game was a bit of the disappointment, but I am accepting this. Recording video in the 3 in the morning and pre-making content at this hour is not the best thing ever, and probably that wasn't the best idea ever, but I can't complain too much about my performance of this vehicle. Obviously, it is not 4,500 combined, but we was aiming for 4,000, right? Let's see, in the end of the day, did we manage to get it or not? 2,700 damage, 900 assisting damage, and we have 20,000 profits, well, to be exact, 19,000 profits, which is okay. We scored the fifth by the experience, we scored second by the damage, definitely not the worst game ever, and in the end of the day, fellas, we have 3,400 damage and 400 assisting damage, so not quite that well. And funny thing, fellas, with the 5,100, I played a bit better. Does it mean 120 sucks? That's the question. Honestly, I think we did as much as we could do in those situations, and some of the situations was simply unlucky, and my focus is not top notch, so I'm accepting this. Anyways, fellas, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and probably whenever you are watching this video, there is a big chance I am back from mini vacation, Saka, meeting my girl family. I am back. I think so. But we'll see when Kylers will release this video. Thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and see you very, very soon. Skill is out. Peace.